God's grace and his peace to you from our risen Lord and Savior, Jesus the Christ. Amen. Our message for today as we celebrate the day of Pentecost is coming from our gospel reading of St. John. As Jesus says, "Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water." Keep this in mind as the title of this message is, "What do you thirst for?" A thirst is a desire. Do you have a desire for Jesus? That's an interesting question. We have to remember what Jesus gives. He gives life, salvation. He gives forgiveness of sins. He is there for us each and every day. Do we desire that? Is that the main focus of our life, our attention, each and every day, each and every moment? More than likely, the answer is no. You see, typically, just think of like drinking water. We live in a world where we're told that we should be drinking more and more water. Fair enough. But are you drinking water every single moment, no matter what you're doing, 24 hours a day? No, there's things like eating, there's sleeping, there's going to work, there's driving in the car, there are other things that we do. So no, we're not drinking water all the time. But what about Jesus? Are we consuming Jesus all the time? Or like water, does our mind often drift in different directions? Well, fortunately for us, as far as the body is concerned with water, there is an internal mechanism that God created within us that says, you're thirsty. And it's a beautiful reminder, it's time to take a break and drink some water. Wouldn't it be nice to have that kind of reminder with God? That sits there and says, yes, there's Jesus. We should be praying. Yes, there's Jesus. We should be opening up God's word and reading it. Yes, there's Jesus. We need to be attending Peace Lutheran Church in Plainfield, Illinois. Yes, there's Jesus, active and daily in our lives. Well, there is a beautiful reminder. Just like we have in our bodies for water, God gives it to us through the Holy Spirit. And strangely enough, God uses water to give us that Spirit. Through the waters of holy baptism, when we are baptized in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we receive that Spirit. And now the Spirit is within us doing what? Pointing us, reminding us that we need Jesus. You see, we need those constant reminders because we live in a world where we get easily distracted. We live in a world where many things pull us in different directions and we're just running out of time doing all the things we want to do. But where's Jesus? The Holy Spirit sometimes nudges us. Maybe the Holy Spirit sometimes kicks us in the butt. Maybe the Holy Spirit just has to give us a gentle reminder that we need to be attached to Jesus. Why? Because Jesus is our life and salvation. Notice the reading from our Gospel of John, where Jesus says, "Whoever believes in me, as the scripture has said, out of his heart will flow rivers of living water." Please keep in mind that this living water was not there before Jesus entered your heart. Jesus brings it. Living water is different than regular water. This water will bring you to eternal life. Not just sustain you for a day or two, but for the rest of eternity. Do we need this living water? The answer is yes, and Jesus freely gives it. And he also sends you the Holy Spirit as that gentle reminder that says, yes, stay attached to Jesus. So as the church celebrates this day of Pentecost, we celebrate it with a lot of joy. Why? Because without the Holy Spirit, we would be lost. We would have given up Jesus. We would have walked away by now. But thanks be to God, he loves us so much that not only was he willing to die on the cross for the forgiveness of our sins, but he also wants to attach himself to us. And he does this as the Spirit guides us through his word and sacraments. Yes, the church needs to continue to remember the Holy Spirit, because without the Holy Spirit, there would be no church. We cannot believe on our own. We cannot remain connected to Jesus on our own, no matter matter how much we try. So we celebrate on this day of Pentecost the Holy Spirit, and we ask the God to continue to send His Holy Spirit active in our lives so that we may receive God's grace and forgiveness and share God's grace and forgiveness with those around us. That's part of that beautiful illustration of living water. Water that comes from Jesus to us, flows through us to other people. So we celebrate, the church celebrates today as an important day, the day of Pentecost. The color is red because it is a festival in the church. So we rejoice and are glad that God sends us the Holy Spirit to keep us connected to Him. What are you thirsty for? Things of this world or the things of God? If you say the things of God, you can thank the Holy Spirit. In God's holy name, amen. Now the peace of God that surpasses all our understanding will continue to guard your hearts and your minds in Christ Jesus our Lord. Amen.